Hello, everyone. I am Ezekiel Bruni. I am a writer, a consultant, and on occasion a web designer. I am here on behalf of VPN Mentor to help you keep your private stuff very private with private internet access, which is a pretty solid VPN, all things considered. So let's just get into the review, shall we? If you are here, you probably already know what a VPN is, and you're just kind of looking for some advice to get you started to help you decide which VPN to choose. This review will be beginner friendly in general. I will include a few things for my fellow nerds, but for the most part, it's going to be very newbie friendly. Those fellow nerds of mine might want to go look down at the links in the description, because there will be a full review linked there of private internet access with all of the tests we've run and all the results we got. A full rundown of every feature, all of that good stuff. I would just like to ask that if you find this video useful or helpful in making your VPN purchasing decisions, give it a like, maybe subscribe, maybe hit that notification bell icon so you can keep up with all of our tips, tricks, guides, tutorials, and yes, more VPN reviews, because we have a lot of stuff coming out pretty regularly. All right, without further ado, let's get into the review. Private internet access has a pretty solid network, all things considered. You can access up to 84 different countries. There are servers all over the world, essentially, which is pretty solid. Not as high as some other services like CyberGhost or ExpressVPN, but a pretty solid number, all things considered. So you can rest assured that there's most likely a server near you. So we've got some servers, for example, here in the US. That ping is a little high, but The ping you see here isn't necessarily representative of the service you'll get. And you can access, you know, just about anything all over the world, which is good, because when you're just browsing and you just want some fast internet with some general anonymity and protection, you know, you want to pick a server that's close to you and not necessarily one in a country far, far away. But you can also access services in a whole bunch of different countries. It's great. Now, I'm going to run a quick speed test while I show you this. Let's go to the US, let's choose Texas, and then click that and hide it so it doesn't show you my IP address. It is connected, so we're just going to reload this again so you don't see my personal IP address. And you can get dedicated IP addresses, which are good for things like banking, because that helps you access, you know, services like banks who they don't like to see your IP address jumping around a lot. But it's not so great for anonymity. So I've connected to Dallas. That ping of 72 milliseconds is a little high, I'll admit, on the high end compared to other services I've used. But still within reason, especially if you're just browsing. I have 115 megabits of full download speed, or actually a little more, it looks like sometimes. Oh, that was... I'm not supposed to have that much. But that works. That works for me. Oh, that upload speed is a little rough. I have 10 megabits of upload speed in general. I should not be losing like 3 whole megabits on that test. But in general, so for download speeds, private internet access is just fine. For upload speeds, that's something you'll need to know. If you need to upload a lot of content like to YouTube or whatever, private internet access, it seems, could hurt your upload speeds now and then. That is not normal. That is not representative of previous tests of mine. But I'm going to leave it in the video because we don't try to make things look that better than they actually are, you know? Honest reviews and all that. But that's enough about the speed and the network. Let's get to why you're really here, if we're honest. Streaming stuff. Now, there is something you should know. Private internet access isn't that good at accessing streaming services like Netflix or Disney Plus via the VPN servers themselves. I mean, it can, it's not bad at it, but these servers, like if you're traveling abroad and if you're going on a business trip or a vacation, there's no reason you should be missing your favorite shows, but streaming services are picky, and if they've decided a show will only be available in the US, then you're going to have trouble accessing it, and they don't like it when people use VPNs to get around that. ExpressVPN is really good at that. Private internet access it has some trouble there, honestly, except when you use the smart DNS service. It has trouble with the VPN servers, but the smart DNS service is much more reliable. Now, what is smart DNS? It's literally a DNS service that you can connect your computer to, and it will You'll use their DNS servers instead of yours, basically, instead of your internet service providers. DNS is the technology that basically tells people, okay, this IP address goes with this domain name. So google.com goes to its X IP address. And when the DNS services are set up right, they can allow you to get past content blocks. Let me show you. You can see it here. You just log into your private internet access account, go to Smart DNS, and you can add devices. And you can choose from several countries, not as many as is offered by the actual VPN service, but you can choose from several countries where you might want to access a streaming service. All right, so here we are. We're on Netflix, Disney Plus. I'm in Mexico. I am not connected to the VPN. Let's show you how it works. Disenchantment, love this show. Gotta check out the new season. As in me, I've gotta check out the new season. As you can see, it's working fine, working properly. And that works too. So again, I'm not connecting to the VPN service this time. I'm using the what I have found to be more reliable Smart DNS service. I'm just going to connect that real quick and show you how it works. You'll want to open up your Windows settings, right? You'll want to go to Network and Internet. You'll want to go connect, choose the connection you use. I'm using a private DNS server that I set up in my own home. That's a local IP. Don't worry about seeing it. It means nothing. So I'm just going to change that quickly to the Smart DNS server numbers I was given, and I'm not going to show you for obvious reasons. We'll run the streaming test then. All right, we're back. I'm reloading both of these just to make sure they work. Again, not connected to the VPN, but using a private internet access service. I don't know why my video flickers like that. Oh, but okay. We're going to load up. Working just fine, working fast. This seems to be working as well. And via thanks to the DNS service, both Netflix and Disney Plus seem to think that I am in the US, which is fantastic. So as you can see, private internet access is pretty good for streaming, but you're not via the VPN. You have to use that separate service. Let's go over some security stuff real quickly. Private internet access does offer access to a variety of security protocols. That's the actual methods by which information is transferred to and from the computers. Some VPN protocols focus on security and some focus on speed, and you can choose between them as you like. It does come with a kill switch, which means that if your VPN cuts out, it will automatically turn off your internet so none of your data leaks. There is a no URL logging policy. So basically, for the most part, whatever you do on the VPN is not being tracked. However, be warned that if a country that ExpressVPN is operating in gets a warrant to track your data, that may or may not hold up. It does work with the Tor browser, and frankly, you shouldn't use the Tor browser without a VPN. Private internet access does support Windows. I'm on Windows 11 right now. It also supports macOS, Android, and Linux, and it has a GUI. It has a graphical user interface for Linux. Oh my God, thank God. iOS, if I didn't mention that already, it supports consoles, Xbox and PlayStation, smart TVs, and it has its own browser extensions. Let's see, I think it's this one. That's the one where I'm not logged in, but you can use the browser extension to control your VPN without having to go to the taskbar and all that. You can connect up to 10 devices at a time. You can install the client on as many as you want, but you can connect up to 10 devices to the network at a time, which is actually huge. It's way better than most options. There is live chat support and email support, and you'll be seeing a clip of how quickly I can get support from private internet access. Okay, this is later on Ezekiel Bruni telling you that normally there would be a clip of me talking to the live chat support to show you how quick and easy it is to get a response from them. I might have gone in at the wrong time of day. It's supposed to be 24/7, but I did not get a response for at least 15 minutes, and then I stopped recording because, honestly, that was taking too long and I was hungry. And all in all, this is one of the cheaper VPNs. In fact, it is quite a bit cheaper than most other VPNs, especially if you pay for a couple years in advance. If you don't mind not worrying about streaming so much and you just want some decent security and relative anonymity for a good price, private internet access is definitely one of your best options. There is a 30-day money-back guarantee, which standard, par for the course. And if you want all of this cheaper, you should look down in the description again for this video, specifically for the link to our coupon page. We have coupons for private internet access, ExpressVPN, CyberGhost, and most other major VPNs. And honestly, that can help you get started a lot cheaper, especially if you're paying for a couple years in advance. On top of the discounts you would already get for paying years in advance with private internet access, that's a lot of money off. Now, private internet access accepts credit and debit cards, PayPal, Amazon Pay, various kinds of cryptocurrencies, and gift cards. Yeah, several brands of gift cards. Now, the final score. Private internet access is probably our best budget option, the best that we've tried. ExpressVPN is still our favorite for a variety of reasons. CyberGhost has more specialized features, but private internet access provides a pretty great server network with decent speeds, all for very cheap. And if you want to stream content from one of a few select places, the Smart DNS service is very good for that. Again, check down in the links below for the full review with all of the details and all of the tests we've run. Check the coupon page for discounts. And if you liked this video, if it was useful to you, please do consider liking, subscribing, and maybe hitting the notification bell. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I hope it was helpful. I enjoyed making it. This is Ezekiel Bruni, signing out.